Hey everybody, it's Christine, and today I've got the Flavors of the Month kit from the Scrap Room, specifically working with the Doodlebug page kit. And if you know me, you know Doodlebug is one of my favorites. So I'm always excited when I get the chance to work with one of their newer collections. This one has your typical Doodlebug bright colors, all the fun and whimsical elements, put together in a fabulous Christmas theme. So what I decided to do, because apparently I'm really into tags this month, is use the tags again. And if you caught my video from earlier in the week, I used tags on my Cartabella layout. So I am using the tags again, this time with all the colors on the layout. I went ahead and printed off a whole bunch of pictures, and the tags are going to bring out the colors of both the pictures and the collection. So you can see they're all different colored tags, and then I've got this gorgeous striped paper. So I'm going to use that really as a focal point for my layout and build up from there. Now, by using these tags, I was able to get 6 pictures onto my layout, which is fantastic. What I used is some pictures from a Christmas party last year, and I just cut them down so that they left a little bit of a side margin on the tag, but didn't worry about the top or bottom. And what that side margin does is it puts some white in between the pictures, and it really like helps to set them apart from one another instead of getting all jumbled together. And so just that little tiny bit of white peeking out can really go a long way. Same reason we mat our pictures, right? It helps break your pictures up and not let them all just kind of get stuck together. So I have got those on there, and you can see already how the layout is coming together. Now, this layout managed to take on a lot of similar elements to my layout with the Cartabella kit the other day. Partially because, again, it's a holiday layout. Also because it's just a technique I like. And when I started going down the tags route, I was like, holy cow, these are going to be kind of similar. But the funny thing is the Cartabella page kit from the Double Shot kit has a really classy, classic Christmas feel. This one has a really lighthearted, fun Christmas feel. So it's kind of cool to see how different they look, even though they've got a lot of similar things. The second thing that's similar about them is that I went for a really big title. So I cut out the words Holly Jolly, and I just used the font called John, J-O-H-N, to cut out my own title. So I made up my own words and I put the letters together, I welded them together, and then I am going to back those with some patterned paper. And you can see right now I am gluing those on, and I am using a dotted adhesive runner for this because it catches on the parts where I want some adhesive but doesn't have like the same elements of like a runner that would be too wide or whatever. And I didn't have any liquid on hand, so this worked great, a dotted adhesive setup. Now, I am typically, when I do cut files, I do back it and then put it all on. However, I decided I wanted to go with one patterned paper, this pink one, and I didn't really want to cut around all of that. So I went back down to my machine and I cut out the same cut file and used the inside to finish off my title. And you know, sometimes, I mean, it's just, there's easier elements to both directions. In this case, I felt like it was easier to just run back down and cut it again and put those in there. I did originally think I was going to do multiple patterned papers here, but I did decide to just go with the pink one. Now, the next thing I'm gonna do is go ahead and embellish throughout the layout, especially along the title there. This page kit came with a lot of really fun ephemera, and so I wanted to take advantage of that and use it in as many different spots as I could, partially because they're just fun, partially because I love it when there's a lot of those options. And so I am using those
to create, if you can see, a visual triangle within my title. So you can see I've got that top point on the left, and then I go down central, and then I go up to the right. In addition to the ephemera in this page kit, it also came with some doodle pops, which are similar to ephemera, but they're three-dimensional. So that also was like really appealing to me to be able to use on my layout, and building it around the title made it really easy to do that. Now, I think everybody out there kind of has their own rules as they create clusters of elements. Some of my rules in situations like this, where I've got several different little pieces and parts going into each cluster. Number one, I want to keep the scale somewhat reasonable. That is not always possible. However, I don't want, like, if I had just a little teeny tiny tree and an elf, it wouldn't be quite right for me. So I liked having like the bigger tree and the bigger elf. I don't want the stars to be super ginormous and have all these teeny tiny little people. Things like that, just trying to keep my scale similar. I also try and mix and match dimensions. And I also try to mix and match what's in there. So I don't want the whole entire cluster to be made up of just ephemera or just enamel dots or just buttons. I try and have some different elements within there, and specifically trying to work sometimes with three different elements within there. Now, I want to add in one more detail. Because I'm already creating a snowy look with my Nuvo drops up there, I am going to go ahead and build on that just a little bit, mostly because I feel like the bottom needs a little bit more grounding to it. There's a lot of color going on at the bottom, and I don't have that, like, in up top, I have that solid red base that is grounding the top portion, but I feel like the bottom doesn't have that grounding going on. So what I'm going to actually do is just tear a white piece of cardstock and put that across the bottom of my layout, giving the appearance of like a snowy hill or a snowy ground, but also bringing that eye to complete the whole layout there at the bottom with that solid white feature there. Thank you so much for being here today. Be sure to check out all the kits this month from the Scrap Room, and we will see you again soon with another video.